Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our live global event. Such a great pleasure for me to be able to welcome all of you. You that are here with us personally to Dubrovnik, to this beautiful venue, to Croatia. Also, a warm welcome to all of you watching us all around the world on our live feed YouTube channel Rimac Automobili. A lot of exciting news happening today. I'm sure that most of you already know what I'm talking about, but I'm not going to go into any details. We're going to go for that to the man himself. Please welcome the founder and the CEO of Rimac Automobili, Mr. Mate Rimac.
Thank you and welcome everyone to this beautiful location in Dubrovnik, Croatia. And thanks for tuning in. We are so excited to finally share the details of this news with you tonight. We are hosting this event to celebrate the most recent news, and we are joined by our shareholders, industry partners and friends at this 14th century fortress with an incredible view of some of the most iconic cars in the world against the background of one of the most iconic cities in the world, beautiful Dubrovnik. Rimac Automobili as a company exists only for 12 years, but what a ride it has been. If somebody told me back then what we are going to tell you tonight, I would have never believed it. Many of you know our story. I was always crazy about cars, even before I could walk or talk. I'm sure many of you are as well. But in high school, I was a national champion for electronics and innovation, and wrote 2 patents when I was 17 years old. After turning 18, I bought a 1984 BMW 3 Series as this was the easiest entry ticket to racing. Soon, the combustion engine of that car blew up and I decided to combine my 2 passions, electronics and cars. Inspired by my fellow Croatian Nikola Tesla and his invention, the alternating current electric motor, I wanted to prove that electric cars can be fast, exciting and better in many ways than combustion engine cars. 2 years after founding the company, the first employees have joined me. We had many tough times, not knowing if the company will survive the next month. Many years of our existence, it was like that. It was just a fight for survival. I thought that our chances for survival were pretty much zero at that time. But that is what made us tough and lean, so we could do a lot with little. My dream was always to develop my own car from ground up, utilizing the potential of electric powertrains, like having an independent motor for each wheel. I have truly believed that a car like that could be superior in many regards to a traditional combustion engine powered car. But having dreams is easy. Realizing such a complex project is a whole nother thing. While we have already shown our first electric hypercar, the Concept One, which was the first electric hypercar at all, it was back in 2011, but it took us 10 years to get from that initial concept and idea to the Nevera, which is the embodiment of my initial vision. It started with just me in a garage, and that was in 2010. We were 8 employees when we have shown the Concept One at the Frankfurt Auto Show in 2011. And just recently, 10 years later, we have broken the 1,000 people mark. What I'm extremely proud of is that we have managed to not only keep the family-like culture while growing so fast, but also build a culture of excellence, focus on the product, discipline, and delivery while having such a fast growth rate, which is very rare. We are continuing to grow fast and expect to double within the next few years. And I always wanted to do this in Croatia and prove this can be done here, despite all the naysayers. As the saying goes, everything is impossible until somebody does it. And I'm very proud that we have attracted people from over 40 countries to call Croatia their new home. But we are also opening up new locations in several countries to have more access to different talent pools. A big challenge in our journey was finding the right investors. While initially, it was pretty much impossible to get investors to invest in an electric car startup in Croatia, led by a 21-year-old guy at that time. Happy to have some of the world's greatest companies as our partners and investors. In 2018, Porsche chose to invest and being a great support. And also, on a personal level, not just on a company level, and thank you for that. In 2019, Hyundai and Kia have also joined us as shareholders. Those partnerships gave an incredible boost to our growth trajectory. As a result of this growth, our company now stretches across 10 different locations in several countries. We have a great global network of dealers selling our products and cars. We are supplying technology to 12 of the world's most prestigious car companies, and we've successfully delivered more than 30 high-profile projects to our industry customers, with many more in the pipeline. Today, we have two businesses that are very complementary and work hand in hand. With our hypercars, we are raising the bar and show what's possible. Our technology business utilizes our know-how of high-performance EV systems to help large OEMs develop and manufacture hybrid and electric cars. We are developing and making battery systems, e-axles, infotainment systems, connectivity, and other products for companies like Porsche, Hyundai, Koenigsegg, Aston Martin, Pininfarina, and many others. One business without the other would have a much harder time, meaning that it would probably be impossible. For example, developing a complex and unique infotainment system for the Nevera would hardly make any sense for the small numbers of hypercars that we are making. It only makes sense if we scale that technology by selling it to other OEMs as part of our technology business. This brings me to the first announcement that we made today. Now that we have two businesses that are quite on a mature stage and a pretty big size, we have decided that it makes sense for the two companies to separate. One focused on hypercars and the other being a technology supplier to the automotive industry. Both companies need to grow and be successful on all levels, including profitability on their own. Still, we will keep the synergies and make sure that, where it makes sense, the companies still work as one. Fast growth requires space, and space has been one of the major challenges of Rimac in the recent years. The Rimac Campus is a very special project to me personally, a project that I have been working on for the last 8 years. It will be the long-term home of our businesses, with space for over 2,500 employees, with all R&D and production facilities that we need. It also includes a test track, testing facility, kindergarten, gym, and many other things to make it the best place for our employees to flourish and give our guests a great experience. It is also uniquely integrated with nature and the community around us, being the only automotive research facility without a fence, welcoming guests from all around the world, as well as the neighbors' kids. Construction of the 200 million euro and 100,000 square meter facility just outside of Zagreb, of the capital city of Croatia, will start in the next couple of months and will be completed by the end of 2023. A month ago, we have presented our all-new electric hypercar, the Rimac Nevera. It is a car that sets new standards in performance and usability, entirely designed in-house from scratch. The Nevera has record-breaking performance, over 1,900 horsepower, 1.9 seconds 0 to 100 kilometers per hour, 412 kilometers per hour top speed, and 120 kilowatt hours of energy. It is a forceful and unexpected force of nature, just like the Mediterranean storm it takes its name from. After investing all of our energy, blood, sweat and tears for the last 5 years into developing the Nevera, it was nerve-wracking to hand it over to journalists to give their verdict on our hard work. It was the more rewarding seeing all of them being absolutely blown away by the car. More importantly, they were not only impressed with the acceleration, but also with the car as a whole picture, with the handling, with the features and the build quality of it. That made us immensely proud. But this is really just the beginning for the Nevera. We are just finishing the homologation and starting the production of customer cars, with the first cars being delivered this year. We are also just heading out to our world tour with the car. We'll be stopping at the most important public and private events with our dealers and customers all around the world. What we've created with the Nevera is the latest in a line of cars that have redefined the limits of performance of automotive. But we are new here, but visionary innovators have been doing this before, and no one has done quite as much to redefine performance as Bugatti. With a history stretching back over 110 years, producing some of the most beautiful and technologically advanced performance cars ever, Bugatti has always been the pinnacle of automotive performance. It has shaped the hypercar sector in what it is today. I said earlier that creating an electric hypercar was my dream, but to be here, sharing the stage with our friends from Porsche and Bugatti, just moments away from announcing the next big development in the Rimac Automobili journey, is something that I have never imagined. Today, we are announcing the creation of a new company, the best hypercar company in the world, called Bugatti Rimac. This is a perfect fusion of Rimac Automobili's fast-paced electrification innovations and Bugatti's 110-year heritage of design and craftsmanship. It is an absolute honor for us to be part of this, joining forces with a company that has done so much to shape the world of performance cars. Bugatti is undoubtedly the most iconic hypercar manufacturer of all time. But now we are given the responsibility to continue Bugatti's 110-year history, using our experience as the world's first EV-only hypercar manufacturer, the creators of the world's fastest accelerating production car, and technology partner to 12 global OEMs to help create another 110 years of history for the future. It's a journey we can't wait to get started on. With splitting up the companies in two, Rimac Automobili, the original limited liability company that I founded 12 years ago, will become Rimac Group, which will be the major shareholder of Bugatti Rimac with a 55% stake. I will retain my original shareholding in the Rimac Group at 37%, Porsche at 24%, Hyundai Motor Group at 12%, and other investors at 27%. Rimac Technology will be 100% owned by Rimac Group, and it will remain an independent company. This independence is incredibly important to our OEM partners, ensuring complete confidentiality and separating shareholders from projects we do for other car companies. I will become the CEO of Rimac Group, leading both Bugatti Rimac and Rimac Technology. The Bugatti Rimac business will develop the future of both Bugatti vehicles and Rimac vehicles through a joint expertise in R&D and other areas. But importantly, Bugatti and Rimac will continue as separate respective brands. At the same time, Rimac Technology stays independent and will continue to work with many automotive companies, the majority of which are outside of our shareholders or the Volkswagen Group, so customers that are other unrelated car companies. The incredible heritage of Bugatti will be completely undisrupted. Molsheim, the incredible site in France, will remain the beautiful home of Bugatti's production with every single car made by hand in Molsheim. Our new campus in Croatia, when completed, will be the headquarters to Bugatti Rimac, home to R&D activities, the production of all Rimac Automobili models, and the production of components and technologies for both brands. For example, the batteries being produced in Croatia for both Bugatti and Rimac. In time, it will house 2,500 employees, some of the most innovative and creative minds in the automotive industry, with a focus on pushing the limits of electrified performance. And with that, I'm honored to invite to the stage the godfather of our relationship with Porsche, Deputy Chairman of the Executive Board and CFO of Porsche, Mr. Lutz Meschke, who can explain a little bit more about what's to come. Lutz.
Hvala lijepo mate, dobrodošli u Dubrovnik. Ladies and gentlemen, it is done. With the signing of the joint venture agreement, the foundation has been established for the new company, Bugatti Rimac. I'm both delighted and very proud that this joint venture has crossed the finish line. Today is a good day for Bugatti and Rimac, Porsche and the entire Volkswagen Group. We can look back on 18 months of intensive negotiations. It took a long time to find the right structure for the new company. And it was not always easy to convince all the stakeholders about the idea and the specific form the joint venture would take. But they were always very productive discussions, and they have led to a very good result. All those involved will benefit, above all, Bugatti's customers. Because this means that the future of this proud and tradition-rich brand has been secured. Bugatti develops and manufactures unique hypercars of the very highest standard that have fascinated its very exclusive customer group for many years. As part of the joint venture with Rimac, Bugatti will still be able to fully demonstrate its outstanding abilities and charisma. Backed by the innovative strengths of Rimac, new and exciting models will be developed that will make the hearts of Bugatti fans all over the world beat faster. The joint venture is the culmination of an extended strategic chain of investments. It started in 2018 when Porsche purchased its first shares in the still young Croatian company Rimac Automobili. This followed initial business and personal contact with Mate Rimac and his fantastic team. It all developed into a very close and productive relationship with partners who complement and enrich each other. Mate Rimac is an exceptional entrepreneur, the likes of which are rare in the history of the automotive industry. He's both easygoing and serious at the same time. He has acquired immense and unique know-how. He rethinks the car and is also able to inspire his team each and every day, motivating them to work towards ambitious goals. And in spite of his tremendous success, he has remained down to earth. Mate, don't ever change. It is always such great fun to work with you. We recognized the enormous innovative potential of Rimac early on. We therefore acted very quickly and decisively when the opportunity presented itself in 2018. Since then, we have successfully increased our shareholding in Rimac Automobili to 24% at present. It has been quite a bold thing to do and not without risk. But this investment has proven itself to be both the correct decision and worthwhile. Rimac has developed exceptionally well, not just on a technological level, but also in terms of value. The company is well on its way to becoming a tier 1 supplier for Porsche. We have already placed high-tech development orders. Today, our good relationship with Mate Rimac is paying off again. As the CEO of the Bugatti-Rimac joint venture, he will lead a highly emotive and important brand into the future. He will also make an important economic contribution to Croatia, while at the same time giving Bugatti's Molsheim headquarters a long-term perspective. With Porsche taking over Volkswagen shares in the joint venture, which resulted from the transfer of the Volkswagen Group's Bugatti shares, we are very happy to be supporting as a strong strategic partner and shareholder. Oliver Blume and I will be represented on the shareholders committee and supervisory board. This means that we will also support the new company in an advisory role. As you can see, Bugatti Rimac has been set up perfectly, right from the start, and is ideally prepared for the future. Porsche will contribute to ensuring that this joint venture becomes a success story. I look forward to it, and I will now hand over to Oliver Blume, and with a big thank you, because he has always given the most fantastic support to this project. Mate, želim ti puno sreće.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Today we are celebrating a big event in the automotive world, the birth of a new manufacturer of hypercars. Porsche and Rimac have agreed a new joint venture between Rimac Automobili and Bugatti Automobile. Together with Mate Rimac, we have reached a contractual agreement. It paves the way for the establishment of the new company. In the first quarter of 2021, Bugatti Rimac will officially launched, subject to agreement by the relevant antitrust authorities. The new company will be a special one. It will unite two strong brands. The first is a legendary and long-established Bugatti brand. It was founded in 1999 by Ettore Bugatti in Molsheim-Alsac in France. Bugatti quickly became one of the most well-known automotive brands in the world. Its fame was built by its iconic sports cars and luxurious saloons, as well as its spectacular success on the racetrack. Bugatti has been part of the Volkswagen Group since 1998, Since then, the more than 300 employees have continued a long tradition, designing and building exceptional hypercars like the Chiron. The second brand is a highly innovative automobile manufacturer, Rimac. 12 years ago, Marta Rimac established it as a startup. Today, the Croatian company is one of the world's most innovative providers of high-tech components for electrified cars. At the same time, Rimac is an emerging manufacturer of electric hypercars. And last but not least, Porsche is a strong shareholder of the joint venture alongside with Rimac. Our brand can look back on more than 70 years of tradition and unique success. We have achieved significant and value-creating growth over the past 10 years. Our workforce has more than doubled. Earnings have increased fivefold. In our core business, we are in an excellent global position. We have an exclusive brand and a strong future-oriented product portfolio. With annual returns of around 15%, Porsche keeps delivering in industry-leading results. In these challenging times of transformation, we have continued to develop. We have a focus on the future, a pioneering spirit, and a passion to become a leader in sustainable mobility. Porsche will be CO2 neutral as early as 2030. And we have shown how to position a long-established company successfully for the future, with ambitious goals and a clear strategy for implementing them. As a strong strategic partner and shareholder, we bring this expertise to the joint venture between Bugatti and Rimac. We have been working closely with both Bugatti and Rimac very successfully for quite a few years. We have come to value Marta Rimac and his very motivated team as an extremely high performance and reliable development partner and supplier. We are convinced of this business model and the enormously innovative power of this company. For this reason, Porsche has acquired a 24% stake in Rimac Automobili. Lutz Meschke has already told you all about the background to this. We also know Bugatti very well, thanks to our years working together as part of the Sport Luxury Group. As a head of this group, I have had a lot of dealings with a unique brand, and I have become a big fan. The special charisma of Bugatti, the high level of craftsmanship in the Molsheim factory, and the enthusiasm of their customers, we want to preserve all of that. We at Porsche are committed to taking Bugatti's tradition forward, permanently securing the future of the brand. I have no doubt that the strongest of foundations are being laid by agreeing this joint venture. With a new collaboration, two companies with strengths that perfectly complement each other are coming together. Bugatti brings a strong, long-established brand, its iconic vehicle design and the Molsheim factory, as well as loyal customer base, its many years of experience in hypercar business and its global dealer network. Rimac is, above all, contributing an extraordinary power of innovation and a successful new startup. Rimac is also bringing a fresh approach to both development and organization. Both partners will benefit equally from this truly ideal combination. From day one, their combined expertise in development, sales and organization will create noticeable added value. This all contributes to a business plan that is financially viable in the future. Furthermore, Porsche has a strong role to play as a strategic shareholder in the joint venture. As a present owner, the Volkswagen Group brings its investment in Bugatti into the joint venture and will transfer this to Porsche. Porsche will hold a 45% share in the joint enterprise. So, what does the future hold in store? The new company will initially produce and sell two hypercars, the Bugatti Chiron and the all-electric Rimac Nevera. In the medium term, We envision the joint development of exciting new Bugatti models. Electrified high-performance models are also now conceivable. The technological and financial base for this has been created. All Bugatti vehicles will continue to be produced with unique standards of craftsmanship in the Molsheim factory. Nothing will change when it comes to the legendary workmanship of Bugatti's luxury products. In conclusion, allow me to say this. We are combining the competencies of Bugatti and Rimac. Their strengths complement each other perfectly. This is a case where 1+1 clearly equals more than 2. The partnership is a win for both sides. The new company is starting up with 2 unique hypercars. Both feature groundbreaking performance and the very highest level of exclusivity. The company will further develop its strong position in the hypercar segment with truly extraordinary new products, with pioneering technological innovations, and with extensive experience in the artisanal manufacture of low-volume models. Porsche will be a strong partner supporting the company in the background with its expertise and financial strengths. The joint venture between Bugatti and Rimac is therefore in a great position right from the start, even for the age of electric mobility. I know that this new company has a great future ahead of it. Thank you very much. And now I would like to please Lutz Meschke and Martin Rimac on stage.
Thank you, Oliver. Thank you, Oliver. Thank you, Lutz, for the trust in Rimac and for being such great partners and friends. We now have this great responsibility to take Bugatti to the future. While we are driven by technology and fully focused on the product, we are also set out to make the business sustainable and profitable. However, never losing focus from the heritage of Bugatti. As Ettore Bugatti said himself, if it is comparable, it is no longer a Bugatti. And this is my favorite picture. We are very excited to show you everything that we are working on for the future. Vive la marque. Thank you very much.